What California firefighters thought was just a pile of ash turned out to be a puppy in need of help. When the sky is hazy and orange and the air perpetually smells like smoke, it just may feel like the end of the world. For so many people, it is. California's raging wildfires burn more than 3.8 million acres of land with no end in sight. In early September, all firefighter crews in Barry County, California, could do was fight the blaze and hope for even the smallest miracle. And they just may have found one. Of the 27 wildfires ripping through California in the summer of 2020, it was the North Complex wildfire, particularly the Bear Fire, that turned Barry Creek upside down. Almost the entire town was wiped out, which left nothing but skeletal homes and ash in its wake. When it comes to wildfires, something as seemingly inconsequential as a change in wind can cause unimaginable destruction, and that's exactly what happened. As people fled for their lives in Barry Creek, the firefighters closed in on the flames. Just because firefighters have been trained to, well, fight fires, doesn't mean it's easy. Containing wildfires is life-threatening work, and the sight of the flames plus the destruction left behind made them desperate for good news. This was especially true for the BCSO search and rescue team. It's their job to sift through the wreckage left behind by the fires. They never know what they're going to find, especially on a property like the one they saw that day in Barry Creek. The BCSO rescue team sifted through the charred remains of what used to be someone's home. Surveying the dead remains of the house, they stepped over blackened furniture and crumbling walls, and the last thing they expected to see was movement. But sure enough, wriggling under the burned furniture was a puppy. Dirty but very much alive, the pup was covered in so much soot that he blended in with the wreckage. The rescuers scooped him up and gave him some water. It was hard to tell from the outside whether or not the puppy was seriously injured, so they brought him to the Valley Oaks Veterinary Center. All the while, they couldn't help thinking, who on earth would leave a puppy behind? It's a question many California-based pet owners have been asking themselves as the unimaginable suddenly becomes reality. What to do in the line of literal fire? If you're forced to evacuate, what if you can't fit your family and pets into your car? For so many pet owners, their pets are their family, so the thought of leaving them behind is almost unthinkable. But for this puppy's family, it was a decision they had to make. With minutes to evacuate their home, their pup was nowhere to be found. According to his owners, there wasn't much time between the evacuation order and the incoming fire. They scrambled to gather up all of their dogs and were horrified when their puppy wasn't among them. They had to make a heartbreaking decision: leave now and survive, or risk everything by searching for him. With orange flames on the horizon, they had no choice but to hope the little puppy's instincts would keep him alive without them. Thankfully, they were right to trust his animal instincts. Even as a puppy, he managed to escape the flames that destroyed the house and town around him. Not every family has been so lucky, however. With very little rain in the forecast, 27 wildfires continued to burn California and claim the lives of at least 29 civilians. The number of animal fatalities, pets or otherwise, is unknown, but there are some steps you can take to keep your own pets safe. Experts at the Ready for Wildfire organization advise pet owners to make an evacuation supply kit for the whole family, including any domestic pets. For all pets, including farm animals, come up with a detailed evacuation plan in case wildfire strikes. Is your pet carrier lodged between some old boxes in the attic? Make sure all pet carriers are easily accessible in case you need to make a quick exit. ReadyForWildfire.org recommends assigning one pet to each family member, which should make evacuating a little easier. Experts advise filling your pet disaster preparedness kit with 2 weeks' worth of food and water, any medications for your pet, plastic bags for waste disposal, toys and treats, blankets, collars, and paper towels. Since no one can control when evacuation orders will happen, it's important to arrange for a neighbor to take your pet for you if you're not home in time. Of course, then there's the ultimate question: what to do if you can't find your pet on time? Since pets are usually more attuned to nature than we are, they may sense fire and take cover before you even realize what's going on. That's exactly what happened to the puppy. There's one thing you can do to make sure your pet isn't alone. Ready for Wildfire recommends that all pets have identification collars so they can be traced back to you. After a rescue puppy was examined by veterinarians, his rescuers came up with a perfect nickname. They decided to call him Trooper. By surviving a wildfire, Trooper has certainly lived up to his nickname. Thankfully, his time at the vet made it clear how the scary circumstances he was rescued under haven't been too damaging. Miraculously, Trooper only suffered minor burns from the fire and will most likely make a full recovery. This is not only good news for his family, who will be reunited with him soon, but for the rescuers too. they were in the same position just 2 years prior. In November of 2018, the most destructive wildfire in California history ripped through the Golden State, decimating everything in its path. The blaze, known as the Camp Fire, destroyed 153,336 acres of land and caused between $7.5 and $10 billion in damages. The Camp Fire was also the deadliest in the state's history and the sixth deadliest U.S. wildfire overall. After scouring the rubble of almost 19,000 buildings and structures consumed by the fire, authorities reported a staggering 86 casualties.